tornado versus microburst. Because one is more well-known than the other, not a lot of people know the distinction between the two weather phenomena. But as WMTW News 8's Kyle Jones explains, there is a distinct difference between the two.
Everything I've seen is points to a classic microburst.
Wednesday afternoon, the National Weather Service ruled out a tornado as a cause of the severe damage that hit Tuesday night.
We see trees down, blown basically in one direction.
But with major damage left by these downed trees and hours of manpower needed to clean it all up, how can you tell the difference?
Yeah, we weren't sure if it was a tornado or what.
The microburst is just a very strong gust of air that hits the ground and spreads out. The tornado needs a lot more components to go well.
Microbursts are formed within thunderstorms and are a downward gust of air.
We see microbursts every year, and it depends exactly on the strength of the wind.
Tornadoes, on the other hand, need a warm source of water, like the Gulf of Mexico, as fuel, and that's something we typically don't have in New England.
Maine averages two tornadoes a year, and that's about what we've been seeing over the last 10 years or so.
While there is a scientific distinction between how the two form, their results can be fairly similar.
Now, downbursts and microbursts, they can still bring winds in excess of 100 miles per hour, which could even be upwards of an EF0 or an EF1 tornado. So both can cause a lot of damage.
In this particular case, we're estimating that the winds were on the order of 70 to 80 miles an hour.
No matter if it's a microburst or a tornado, the big concern is wind speed. So experts say when you hear a warning, you should take cover in an interior room with your loved ones to stay safe.
And the clouds got dark and the rain came down, and it was just scary. That's the only way I can say it. Luckily, nobody was hurt.
The National Weather Service says they'll gather the data collected here to determine the types of storms that we see in New England. In York, Kyle Jones, WMTW News 8.